Hello, I'm Holly Markovich, and I am your instructor for MAT 263 Brief Calculus. We're going to get started with just a very simple application of Excel. This will be the first video that you see that will quickly take you through some basics. You open up Excel through your Start menu. So you go to Start and go to Microsoft Excel, and you should end up in the same screen that I'm in now. If you notice, I am in my Home tab. We generally will be working with the Home tab. We will also work with Insert, which will allow us to enter scatter plots. Page layout is something similar to Word, where you may, if you're going to print, you'll be in there at some point. Data is a tab that we often use. Data, the What If Analysis tab, and then eventually Goal Seek. But what I want to do this morning is just get you just get you started with entering some basic information. So one of the things I want you to see is that each cell, that's what these little boxes are called, cells, are labeled by the column and the row. So this would be cell A1, this would be cell D4, this would be cell F8. And if you notice up here, you can also see the name of the cell. Let's go back to A1 for a second, and in A1 we're going to type in an X, and then in cell B1 we're going to type in F of X. X is going to provide the column where we're going to enter in our domain values, the values that we're going to enter for X. F of X is where we're going to enter our formula. What I'm going to do off to the side is I'm going to insert a text box. And the reason that I'm going to insert a text box is because I want you to see the function that we're going to work with in this simple example. So I'm going to type in -2x² - 3x + 5. So that'll be the function that we're going to work with. Having a little bit of computer issues here this morning. I hope that wasn't too distracting. I'm going to come over now and let's work with our domain for a second. So with X, let's enter 0 and then let's enter 2. And suppose I wanted to skip count by 2s up to 20. All I would have to do is highlight the 0 and 2, and when you do that, you can see that you have a dark hard line around 0 and 2, and you've also got the little drag tool, that little box that's right in the corner. If you drag that tool, you can drag it down to 20. Of course, you could drag it as far as you wanted, but we're going to work with it to 20 right now. Those are the values that we're going to want for the domain. You could do that. You could skip count by ones, and that's obviously just putting a one here. You could skip counts by 0.5. You could skip count by any value that you wanted using that same technique. To enter a formula, you're going to go to the row, the cell B2, which is in the same row that your first X domain value is in, and we're going to look at our formula and type it in. To type a formula in Excel, you always start with an equal sign. Excel is very handy, but you have to tell it exactly what you want it to do. So we're going to say -2, but then we're going to say times. We never type in X. We're going to click our cell reference. So when I click on the 0, the A2 cell reference pops up, and then we're going to hit Shift-6, which is (2), -3 times, again, I'm going to click on my cell that has the 0 in it, which is A2, +5. So once you've got your formula looking like mine, go ahead and hit Enter. What happens is, if you look, that formula now, what will happen because of the way that we've entered this is, it's a formula that I can use. I can take my drag tool again and pull those values all the way down. Okay? If I undo that, there's another trick, especially if we have long columns with lots of values. If you just double click that little drag tool, it will fill in for you. Once you have those formulas, if you wanted to change a value, suppose instead of 8, you wanted that value to be 9.05. Well, you type in 9.05, and then you can see immediately that your value for f of x changes. Let's do one last thing on this quick early video. What I'd like for you to do is I would like for you to highlight the two columns that are filled with the information from this simple function. Once you have those columns highlighted, you're going to go to Insert, Scatter Plot, and you're going to pick the scatter plot that has no lines through it. It's just going to be comparing the pairs of the values. And notice what we have there. We have a quadratic function that's opening down. We could see that already. But if you click here, any of these points, you can see that this is the series of values that are coming directly from the values that we put in. We'll be doing more with those scatter plots, but I hope that you can review this simple video a couple of times and get a gist of these Excel basics if you've never used Excel before.